Hi everyone, welcome back to my podcast. I'm Dakota and this is my knitting podcast. My little room and corner on the internet where I get to talk about how much joy knitting brings me and just anything about knitting. Thank you for watching. I wasn't expecting people to watch, so this is pretty exciting. Knitting is a gift that God has given me that has brought me so much joy, and I want to share the joy with all of you and hopefully connect with people who also feel the same. So that's why I'm doing this, and thank you for being supportive of me. I am filming on my phone this time, so if this is better, let me know. I guess I'll find out if this is better. But yeah, hopefully the lighting and quality is better. It is, the lighting outside keeps changing, so we'll see. It is what it is. I'm not bothered by it, so. Yeah, this video is not like the others that I've made so far. I don't have many finished objects or works in progress or acquisitions. So if you wanna see those things, you can go to my last video. But this video will be about my fall knitting plans. So basically what I have planned for September, October, November-ish. We're getting into winter kind of at that point, at least here in New Jersey. So yeah, mostly just September and October and early November. It's not that much. Right now my knitting shelf up there is pretty sparse. I am going on a trip to Portugal in 11 days, so I've been trying to budget for that. It's just a trip for me. I'm just going alone. I've never traveled outside of the country alone before, so this will be exciting, but it has left me needing to budget and not spend all of my money on yarn, which has been so hard for me because it's September and all of my favorite colors basically are in yarn form and being released, and there's so many new yarns being released, so many patterns, so it's been difficult, but it's not the end of the world. It's just been a lesson in not being so impulsive in buying yarn, and typically I'm not. Like, I do buy my yarn based on projects, unless I'm like visiting a yarn store and I see a yarn I like, then I'll usually buy a small quantity and make socks out of it or something, I don't know, something small. So for this video, I don't have any sweaters quantity of yarn. It's really just accessories and yarn that I, or patterns that I plan to make that I have not gotten yarn yet for. So it really is just bare bones. These are my plans, and in future videos you'll get to see these plans come to fruition, but this is just me talking about them, and hopefully it will inspire me, it will inspire you, and I would love if you would share in the comments what you plan on making, and some designers that you would recommend, because really I just, like, right now I just have petite knit planned and my favorite thing's knitwear, so I would love to hear some other smaller designers that you'll be making their patterns this fall. So yeah, let's get started. The first yarn I have, I've actually already talked about in my last podcast, and this is the Birchgrove yarn, the sock set in the colors Meadow and Redwood. I will be making socks with this, and I think this will be what I take to Portugal with me, because I know a set of socks will take me a week. So I think, I don't know. I mean, the plane ride there is 7 hours. It is a red eye, so I hope I can sleep, but knowing me, I won't, so I'll just be up all night knitting. And then the plane ride back is 8 hours, and then all that time while I'm in Portugal that I'll want to be knitting. So I would like to take this. I really wish, the one project I'm going to talk about, maybe I'll go to my local yarn store and try to get yarn for that before I leave, because I would really like to take that also. Anyway, this will be the first one of this video. or that I make. I don't know what I'm talking about. I have to cake it up, and then I'll post it on my Instagram. And I think it's gonna be beautiful. I haven't decided how long I wanna make them. I think I'm gonna make them pretty long because it seems that every time I make socks, I have so much yarn left over. Like I just finished this pair of socks that I'll show in a different video. They're on my Instagram though. And I use this yarn and I still have so much of this yarn left. Like, what do I do with this? I don't know. So we'll see. I think, like, typically I'll do, if I'm not making short socks, I do a 20 row cuff, 50 row leg, and then my heel, and then my foot is 65 rows, not including the toe. But I still end up with so much left, so I think I might make these a little bit longer. We'll see. There's options. And yeah, I will, I mean, you'll see them eventually once they're a finished object. The next thing I have is this yarn. It's a mess right now. I got this yarn when I was a baby beginner knitter, and I have to cake this all up, but I had gotten it and my skill level just wasn't, I was trying to make a beanie and I was failing miserably. But now I think I could utilize this yarn a lot better. So yeah, I was trying to make this beanie and it doesn't look bad. It definitely, I mean, it looks too small, but I think it would stretch out to fit. I also had this huge laddering here, so yeah, this needs to get ripped back. And I think what I'm gonna make with it instead is a Sophie scarf, or another beanie. I think that this color does, it flatters me, but I don't know, I'm really feeling making a Sophie scarf with this. I think in the bigger size, I think that would be really cute if I made it before going to Portugal, because the weather there is pretty mild. Like, I was just looking, it was in like the 70s this week, so I think which isn't cold at all, but compared, it always feels colder when you're transitioning into like 70 degree weather from like 90 degree weather. So I think I will try to make this before I leave for Portugal so I can have it. This yarn is by Rowan. I don't know what color, but it's this teal, like very deep bluish green. And I don't even know what consistency is it. It is, I got it so long ago. So we'll see, I'll try to find out and I'll leave it in the description below. So yeah, that's that. And then I have some yarns that I had pre-ordered that I'm going to talk about, and I will pop them all up on the screen for you and talk about what I'm going to make with them. So the first one I got, the first three are all from the Sewrellayarn New York, or Autumn in New York collection. I loved all of the yarns that she released. The whole collection just really resonates with me because I live so close to the city and I adore going into the city, just taking day trips and walking around, going to Central Park, going to Brooklyn, getting coffee, knitting. I just love the city. Don't know if I'd want to live there, but just to go for the day has always been really nice. I have biked in the city. I'm planning on going and doing a run in Central Park soon, so I just love the city. So this collection was very exciting for me. The first one I got was the colorway Sweater Weather, and I got it in the cashmere sock yarn. She has a bunch of different types of yarn, consistency, textures you can get. So I got the cashmere sock and I'm planning on making a Oslo hat with it. Maybe mohair edition, I don't know. These yarns probably won't be here until like the end of October, so maybe longer, I'm not sure. But if I find a mohair that I think will pair really well with it, then I'm just gonna get that and make the mohair edition. But just the regular Oslo hat seems really nice too. And then if I have any leftover from that, I also got the colorway Brooklyn, which is kind of out of my comfort zone, but I got it in the classic sock fiber, and I'm just planning on making socks with it. If I have any leftover, maybe a Sophie scarf for a gift. I think that colorway is very, more like masculine, I guess. So maybe I would gift it to one of my male friends. But I plan on making some socks with it, and if I have any of the sweater weathers yarn left over, I will do like a contrast color. She had released a sock set with those two colorways, so, and I didn't, since I was already gonna get the sweater weather, I didn't want to buy it in a sock set, because I figured I can just utilize the two separately in different ways, and then if I have any leftover, combine them. So that will be a pair of socks. And then the last one I got was the color brick, and I got it in the cashmere sock again. I really want to make a pair of mittens with that yarn. If I can find a type of mohair, a color of mohair to go well with it, I would love to make mittens with that and mohair. But I think the deep red brick color will look so cute as mittens, and I'm very excited for that. I haven't decided if I'm gonna do them on DPNs or on Magic Loop, but I hate Magic Loop, so hopefully I can figure it out on using DPNs. But yeah, if you ordered from that collection, I would love to know what you got. I think every colorway was beautiful. So yeah, I would just be interested to know what you got. The other pre-order that I have was another sock set from Birchgrove. And that one was in the colorway Cabin. That's just gonna be socks and anything left over. I don't know what I'll make, but I'm very excited to make socks with that. And yeah, I feel like I'm gonna have a lot of these yarns left over, so I would love to make like a scrap project with all of this, like scrap socks or something. I think that would be exciting. And I think that's it for pre-orders and accessories that I have planned this fall. Now moving on to garments. So I have one with me right now, but it's not going to be for very long. So I had started, I mentioned this in my last video and I posted about it on Instagram. I have the Monday sweater here with me and I'm still like on the yoke, so it's all bunched up and not looking very cute. But so far I really do like the pattern. The yoke is taking quite long, but this is all gonna get ripped back. So when I was buying the yarn for this pattern, I misread it. And there were two red flags that I noticed not soon enough. The first one was when I got the yarn, it was in like 50 gram balls, and I was like, that's weird. I thought like per the pattern it would be like enough, so I only ordered 5 skeins of it, but it clearly was not enough. So I was like, okay, that's weird. I'll just order more when I need to. So first red flag. Second red flag was as I was knitting it on 4mm needles, my hands were starting to ache really bad. I was like, why are my hands so achy? This is weird. This has never happened before while I'm making a sweater. Like, the yarn just felt so thick. And the pattern calls for a strand of mohair and a strand of tin pure Gynt yarn. I really don't know how to say that. It's a Sandnes Garn yarn. So sorry for my pronunciation. Anyway, yeah. It calls for that, and I ordered a strand of mohair and the regular pure Gynt yarn, not the tin version, which I think just means thinner than the regular one. I think mohair is like flying into my throat. Yeah, so it ended up just being a really bulky yarn, and it is very beautiful. Like, the color is beautiful. My stitches, I think they look very nice, but and I was so hopeful. Like, I kept going. I was like, no, I'm not gonna rip this back, but I really just do not like how this feels, and I don't trust it enough to wait for blocking for it to soften up. It's very rustic, it's very rough, and does not feel good in my hands, and I don't think it's gonna feel good to wear. So I'm just gonna get a different yarn and rip it back. And you know, I can utilize the pure Gynt yarn for something else. I'm just sad to rip back all this progress, but it's not worth it if I'm not gonna wear it. Like, there's no sense in continuing to keep going. Like, just have to put your pride aside and do what's best. So yeah, once I figure out which yarn I'm gonna use for that, hopefully I'll order it today. I will post it on my Instagram and do an update on there, because I had posted about how I picked the wrong yarn. But I do still want to use, where is it? The mohair that I got. It's Knitting for Olive in the color Powder. I would still really like to use this because I have 4 more skeins of it. So we'll see. It'll be a lot of fun pulling back all of the mohair. Mohair is definitely getting in my throat. Anyway, so that's that. Disappointing, but it's not the end of the world. It's part of knitting. Knitting is just a frustrating hobby. It can be. It's also such a lesson in patience and taking your time with things. Yeah. Anyway, that's that. The other two that I have planned, I would really like to make Camisole number 8 by My Favorite Things Knitwear. I don't know what yarn I would use for that, but I think that's where I would go to the yarn store in the next week to buy the yarn for that. I've never done cables before, so I think that would be really fun. I really want to learn how to do cables, and also I think I would just modify it to have either like a fold over collar or like more of a turtleneck type of thing. So yeah, there's that one that I want to do, and then there is the caramel sweater. I've been eyeing the caramel sweater ever since I saw it, like when I was a baby beginner, and yeah, I've always wanted to knit that sweater. So that might be my birthday cast on. I don't know, my birthday's not until the end of November, so if I could get Monday sweater and camisole number 8 done by the end of fall, I would be very happy, as well as all of the socks and things. Yeah, I think that's it for my plans. Obviously, I will keep everything updated on my Instagram, so I'll link that down below if you want to follow me there. In terms of future videos, I don't know what it's going to look like for September because I will be gone. I've thought about vlogging, but we'll see. I don't know like how I'm going to feel while I'm in Portugal, and I don't want to just like whip out my phone. If anything, I will just have like some footage and then hopefully have another podcast when I get home to New Jersey. So that's that. Hopefully I see you again in September. It's only the 7th, so I'm hopeful that I'll have another video by October, but I'm not going to stress about it. So if I don't see you, have a wonderful rest of your September, and I hope you enjoy the beginning of the fall season. And if I do see you again, then I'll see you in the next video. Yeah, have a good day. I guess, I don't know, I'm really bad at goodbyes, and I don't really know how to end videos, so I'm just gonna say goodbye. Goodbye, see you later.